Those who have joined the class may give their attendance in the chat box. I repeat, those who have joined the class may give their attendance in the chat box. Format is, okay, I am writing the format. Yes, one student has written, format will be name slash your section slash roll number. Name slash section slash roll number. This is the format. Okay, it is 2:15 p.m. So I will not waste much time. Just give me a minute so that I can present my screen first. Can anyone please respond whether the slides are visible or not?
Yes, sir. It's visible.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. So, good afternoon to all of you. I think in the last lecture, Abhishek sir has discussed the epicycloid and hypocycloid part. If anyone can respond.
Yes, sir.
Fine. Okay. So, today what we will do is we will discuss the last part of epicycloid and hypocycloid, that is how to draw the tangent and normal to the given curve. And with this, we will cover one more topic, that is the last part of your first assignment, that is involute. With this, today we will try to cover, or we will try to complete the first lab assignment. Then after that, I will let you know that how you will submit that lab assignment within the given time period. Fine. So let us start the first topic of today's class, that is how to draw the tangent and normal to the epicycloid or hypocycloid. Method of drawing tangent and normal is same. Whatever method you will follow, the same method you have to follow for hypocycloid also. So far what you know? So far you know how to generate this epicycloidal curve. Once you have got this epicycloidal curve, how to get the tangent and normal? Assume that I want to draw tangent and normal to this particular epicycloid curve at this particular point, that is point M. This is your M. Fine. I want to draw tangent and normal through this point of the epicycloid. What I will do? The very first step is take your compass and the length of the compass will be equal to the radius of the rolling circle. Which one is your rolling circle? The small circle is your rolling circle, and radius will be how much? That is nothing but CP. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Hello. Is it clear?
Yes, sir. Repeat once more.
Repeat once more. Say, I want to draw tangent and normal at point M of this epicycloidal curve. What I will do? The very first step is, I will take my compass, and the length of the compass will be equal to the radius of the rolling circle. The small circle is my rolling circle, and from the diagram it is very much clear that the radius is nothing but the length CP. Now it is clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir. So, this much length I will take, this is my CP, this much length I will take in my compass. Then, I will place my compass at this particular point M, from where my tangent and normal will pass. You put one leg of your compass at point N, then you have to cut an arc. On which line you have to cut an arc? You have to cut an arc on this central line. Can you see the central line? C, C1, C2, C3, C4, C5, C6, C7 and so on. This is your central arc line. On this central arc line, you have to cut an arc of length equal to CP. Is it clear? Any doubt so far? Hello?
Sir, can you just tell me that how you are getting the point M, sir?
You can take any point. My aim is to draw tangent and normal at any given point on the epicycloid. This point M you can take over here also. This point M you can take over here also. You can take it anywhere. I have assumed this point. Then what I have taken? I have taken my compass. Length of the compass is nothing but equal to the radius of the rolling circle. That is nothing but CP. Then I will place one leg of my compass at this point M, from which my tangent and normal will pass. Then I will cut an arc of length equal to the radius of this rolling circle, that is CP, on this central arc line. This is that arc. Is it clear? Then what you need to do, join this arc point with the center point O, this central point O of the directing circle. Join that arc point by a straight line in such a way that this arc point, you have to join it with the center point O of the directing circle. That means this line. This is that line. Join it with scale. Done. Now, if you see this straight line which you have joined, it is intersecting the directing circle. This is my directing circle, a part of the directing circle. It is intersecting the directing circle at this particular point. Fine. Then what you do, you just name this point. Say this point is N. Then join NM. Join NM and extend. This NM line is known as your normal line. And then you take the protector, align the protector with this normal line, and draw a 90 degree line that will pass through point M, intersecting this normal line, and this line will be your tangent line. This is the process by which you can draw tangent and normal to epicycloid. The same process you have to follow for hypocycloid also, but in hypocycloid, whatever thing you have to do, you have to do inside that curve. Is it clear? I will not make him or her join. Already it is 2:20 p.m. If I will do it all the time, then I will do it. Okay. So is it clear? Any doubt so far?
No, sir.
Okay. This process is same for hypocycloid also. Only the process will be in reverse manner. That means inside the curve you have to do. Any doubt? Should I move forward? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, say for hypocycloid, I will show you for hypocycloid also how to draw the tangent and normal. Okay. In the last class, we also learned how to draw a hypocycloidal curve. That is when the rolling circle rolls inside the periphery in anticlockwise direction over the directing circle, then the curve which we get is known as hypocycloid. This is the hypocycloid curve. If I want to draw tangent and normal to this hypocycloid, what I will do? First of all, take any point on the hypocycloid curve where you have to draw tangent and normal. Let us take a point. Say I want to draw tangent and normal to this point, this particular point. Fine. Say the name of this point is M. What I will do? I will take my compass. I will measure the length of the compass equal to the radius of the rolling circle. This is the radius of the rolling circle, CP. Take this much length in your compass. Then place one leg of your compass at point M and the other leg on which the pencil is attached, you have to cut an arc. On which curved line you have to cut an arc? You have to cut an arc on this central curved line containing centers C1, C2, C3, C4, C5, C6, C7, C8. So let us cut an arc. So, I have cut an arc on this central arc line. This is that arc of length equal to CP. Next, what I need to do? I have to join this arc point with the center point O. This is the center point O by a straight line. And I will extend. See, in this case, you have to extend this line upward. Why? Because directing circle is on the outer periphery. In epicycloid, directing circle was in the inner periphery. Can you guess the difference?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Fine. So, this is that point. Say this point is N. Now, join M to N. Join MN and extend. This MN line is your normal line. And if you want to draw a tangent, just take your protractor, align your protractor with MN line at point M and draw a 90 degree line. That 90 degree line will be your tangent line. So this is your tangent line. Say this tangent line is T, T dash. T, T dash is tangent line and M, N is my normal line. This is the process by which you can draw tangent and normal to a given hypocycloid and to a given epicycloid. Any doubt so far? Please respond whether the steps are clear or not.
No doubt, sir.
Yes, sir, clear.
Yeah.
Okay. So this was the process by which you can draw a tangent and normal to an epicycloid as well as to an hypocycloid. Next, we will move on to the last part or the last problem of the first lab assignment, that is involutes. Involute is also a gear teeth profile. Again, there is a method by which we can generate that involute profile. So, let us move on to the involute profile curve. Yes. See, it is written the definition of involute. First of all, let us understand what is an involute. Then we will see how to generate the involute profile. What is involute? Involute is okay. What is an involute? Involute is a locus of a free end of a string when it is wound round a circular pole. What is involute? Involute is a locus at free, or it is a locus of a free end of a string when it is wound round a circular pole. That means with an demonstration, I am making you understand what is an involute. Can you see me? Please respond whether you
yes,
can.
Sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Assume that this is a string of some length called L. This is a string of some length called L. Now, if you see the definition, what is the definition of involute? It is a locus of a free end of string when it is wound round a circular pole. That means this string is having two ends. One is this particular end, second one is this end. Fine. Say if this particular end is free, and how I will create an involute? If I wrap this particular wire over a circle, assume that the cross section of my finger is circle. Assume that the cross section of my finger is circle. If I try to wrap the length of the wire completely, that means how I can do it? See, I can wrap it like this. Yes or no? This is the process. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Sorry, any doubt? Okay. No, please don't write in the chat box, because since I am opening the PPT, so every time it is not possible for me to read the chat box. So please unmute yourself and then say yes or no. Okay, fine. So if you see this process, the wire is completely wrapped. I have completely wrapped this wire over the circle. Assume that the cross section of my finger is circle. Fine. So during this process, can you please tell me how much a maximum length of wire I can wrap on a circle at a time? Maximum, how much length of wire
circumference
I can
of it
wrap on a circle at a time?
The circumference of it.
Yes, the circumference of the circle, because I know that the circumference of the circle is pi d or 2 pi r. So maximum I can wrap a circumferential length of 2 pi r length on a circle. That means L means what? L is my length of the wire. That length of the wire should be equal to the circumference of the circle, that is 2 pi r. Then only I can wrap completely that length of wire over a circle. Is it clear so far? Okay. So now how I can get an involute? Now if you try to unwrap the wire, without disturbing the circle, circle is fixed throughout, circle is not moving, circle is fixed throughout without disturbing the circle. If you try to unwrap the wire, what will happen? Say at time t equal to 1 second, this is the position of the free end of the wire. At time t equal to say 10 seconds, this is the position. Can you see the difference?
Yes, sir.
What is the difference? Difference is the if I assume the length of the wire means the amount of the length that I am unwrapping to be the radius of a circle. When I act after, when you unwrap this wire after each and every interval of time, what is happening? Some
radius is increasing.
Radius is continuously increasing. So there will be a case. There will be a case when you completely unwrap the wire. This is the condition. When you have completely unwrapped the wire, that is equal to what? That is equal to the circumferential length, that is 2 pi r, which is equal to the length of the wire. So while unwrapping, when you are unwrapping this wire, the end, this is the end of the wire. This end point you have to trace. You have to trace this end point after each and every interval of time. When you trace this end point, you get a curve, and that curve is known as involute. This is the physical definition of involute. Now it is clear. If it is clear, then I will go back to the construction part.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So now I am showing you the construction part, how we can draw an involute. Okay. Now there are three cases in involute. Case number one, when the length of the wire is equal to the circumferential length, that is L is equal to 2 pi r. Case number two, when length of the wire is more than the circumferential length, that means L is greater than 2 pi r. And third case, when length of the wire is less than the circumferential length, that is L is equal to 2 pi r. Fine. So I have told you that there are total three cases possible in involute. Now I am showing you the demonstration. You tell me which case I am talking about, because in the question directly that case will not be mentioned. You have to read the problem accordingly. You have to decide I have to draw involute for which case, case number one, case number two, or case number three. Accordingly, that involute profile will change. Fine. Okay, case number one. This is the length of the wire. Tell me which case. This is which case. First case is L is equal to 2 pi r. Second case, L greater than 2 pi r. Third case, L less than 2 pi r. This is which case?
Second case, L greater than 2 pi r.
L greater
how,
than
2
pi r.
How come it is L greater than 2 pi r? This is L. This end point of my finger and this end point of my finger is the length of the wire. What I am doing? See the demonstration completely. What I am doing? I have completely wrapped the wire or not?
Equal to.
If I completely wrap the other end of the wire over the circle, then this point will exactly lie on the periphery of the circle. That means this is which case? This is case number one. L is equal to 2 pi r. Okay, second case. Now you answer. Same L, this is length of the wire. L, I am wrapping it. Yes, this is the case. Now tell me, this is which case?
L greater than 2 pi
r. Over. Now you are left with two more cases. L is greater than 2 pi r, L is less than 2 pi r. This is which case?
L greater than 2 pi r.
L greater than 2 pi r. L is greater than 2 pi r. Can you see this much length is extra? This much length you haven't wrapped. This is unwrapped length. How much is extra? Overall is L. L is the length of the wire.
L minus 2 pi r.
2 pi r is the circumferential length. So L minus 2 pi r. This is that extra length. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Because this portion will be, this much portion will be outside the circle. That means length of the wire is big and circumferential length is small. L minus 2 pi r. This is that extra length. This is greater than case. There will be a change in the profile. Third case. Third case is same length of wire, but this much portion is say behind this line. Say this much portion of the length is behind my this finger. That means this portion is over here. Then this is which case? Third case, some portion of the length of the wire is behind the circle. How much it is behind? In this case, circumferential length will be more. That is 2 pi r is more, l is less. So that behind length will be how much? 2 pi r minus l. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Fine.
Yes, sir.
There are three cases possible. Now I will show you one by one what is the change in the profile of the involute. Fine. Let us see. Let us read the problem. Draw the involute of a circle when string length is equal to circumference of the circle. That means in this case, L, that is length of the wire or line, is equal to circumference of the circle 2 pi r. For this case, how we can draw an involute? Okay. Step number one is what? Since involute is coming out from a circle. Involute is coming out from a circle. So first of all, I should know the radius or the diameter of the circle in order to draw the circle. So in question, some information regarding radius and diameter will be given to you. With the help of that information, first you will construct a circle. Is it clear?
But how many times are we wrapping it?
You are wrapping it for one revolution, for 360 degree, for 2 pi r length.
Okay, only one.
Yes, one revolution. Okay. Because if you wrap the entire length of wire for one revolution, you will get one involute. If you do the same process for second time, you will get the second involute profile and so on.
Okay, okay. Got it.
Okay. Fine. So first step is what? By the help of given information present in the problem, first I will draw a circle of given radius or diameter. Is it clear? Any doubt? Please respond, because I cannot see the chat box now because I have
made full. No doubt, sir.
Okay, fine. What is the next step? So far you know, if you want to get a cycloid, or if you want to get epicycloid or hypocycloid, you have to divide your circle into some equal number of parts. So here also, if you want to get the different locus points of involute, you have to divide your circle into some equal number of parts. And minimum, if you want to get a good profile involute, minimum you have to divide your circle into 8 number of equal parts. You can do it more also, it's your choice. If you take more number of, if you divide your circle into more number of equal parts, you will get the better profile of involute. But minimum 8, you have to do it. So let us divide the given circle into 8 number of equal parts. I will not repeat the procedure because you already know how to divide any circle into 8 number of equal parts. And then after that, what you need to do? You need to name the different arc points that you have cutted on the circle in order to divide it into 8 number of equal parts. As 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And a number should be in anti-clockwise direction, because involute is starting from here, like this it is starting. So you have to number the circle in anti-clockwise direction, like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Is it okay so far? Any doubt? Any doubt so far?
No, sir.
No, sir.
Okay.
No, sir.
Next step is, you know, if I want to get an involute, I need a circle I have drawn, as well as I need a line, this line I want of some length. Then only this condition is satisfied. We have drawn a circle. Now I need this line. So again, some informations related to the length of the line or the string length will be given to you in the problem. Say for this problem, length of the line is 150 mm. 150 mm means I can take 15 centimeter length in my scale and I can draw that line. But this line should be tangent to this circle like this. That means from point A, you have to draw that line. Which line? That line which you will wrap over the circle in such a way that this line is making a tangent to this circle at point A. That means this particular angle will be equal to 90 degree. Then only this line, this horizontal line will be a tangent line passing through point A of the circle. Is it clear so far? Any doubt?
No, sir. Clear.
No, sir.
Okay. No. Next step is assume point A. Now, this is which case? The case is L is equal to 2 pi r. That means this is my L. This length is my L. This length is my L. And since L is equal to 2 pi r, completely I can wrap this length over circle. Yes or no? So this particular length, say this is point A, this is the other end point of the line. This length is nothing but L, which is equal to 2 into pi into r. Is it clear? Any doubt so far?
No, sir.
Okay. Next. So if you see, you got the two extreme end locus points of involute. Which point? One is this point and another one is this point. That is, the two ends of the line are nothing but the two end locus points of involute. Yes or no? Please respond.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Next step is, so assume that the other end point of the line is P and the first end point of the line is A or point number 8. Next. This length is how much? This length is equal to pi d, which is equal to L. Next. Since you have divided your circle into 8 number of equal parts to get 8 different locus points of involute, you have to divide this line. Which line? This L line, which is equal to pi d line, again into 8 number of equal parts by set square method, which I have shown you in the second class, I guess. By set square method, you have to divide this tangent line, initial tangent line, which is nothing but the length of your string, which is equal to pi d for this case, into 8 number of equal parts by set square method. Is it clear so far? Any doubt so far?
Yes, sir. No doubt, sir.
Okay. Now I need 8 different locus points of involute. How I will get? You will get those 8 locus points if you draw tangent line passing through 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 arc points of circle. That means like this. From point 1, which is the first arc point of the circle, if you draw a tangent line, you don't know the length of this tangent line, just draw an infinitely long tangent line. Similarly, from point 2, draw an infinitely long tangent line. Similarly, from point 3, from point 4, from point 5, point 6, point 7. From point 8, no need to draw the tangent line. Initially, already we have drawn the tangent line, which is nothing but the length of the string. Is it clear so far? Any doubt so far?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So if you see that we have got the first locus point and we have got the last locus point. In between locus points, I have to find out. That means I need to find out six locus points. How I will get the second locus point? I will get on this tangent line, which is passing through point one of the circle. For that, what you will do? You will take your compass and measure length 1P. This 1P length you have to measure. Which length? This one and this P. This much length you take in your compass. Place one leg of your compass at this point 1. And on this infinitely long tangent line, cut an arc. This is the second locus point of your involute, P1. Is it clear or should I repeat once again?
Repeat the second.
Okay. I got the first locus point. I got the last locus point. In between six points, I need to get involute. How I will get it? In order to get the second locus point, which I know it will lie on this first tangent line, passing through the first locus point of the circle. So this is the first arc point of the circle. Find out this first arc point in your initial tangent line. This is your first arc point. Fine. Now measure this length from 1 to P. Why P? Because P is the starting locus point of my involute. So measure this length in your compass. Place one leg of your compass at this particular first point on the circle. This is that tangent line passing through the first locus point. Cut an arc. This arc length will be equal to this 1P, this horizontal length. So you will get the second locus point of the involute, that is P1. Is it clear now? Any doubt?
Yes,
the same thing you have to repeat for the other points of the circle. That means if you want to get the third locus point, I know that the third locus point will lie on this particular tangent line passing through point arc point number 2 of the circle. So what I will do? I will identify this second arc point in my initial tangent line. This is my second arc point. Now I have to measure the distance by the help of compass. So tell me what will be the distance for in this case. In this case, what will be the distance? What will be the distance in this case? It will be
2P.
2P, this much length. This is my 2P. This is your 2P. Take this much length in your compass, place your compass at this point and cut an arc. So this is your 2P. This is your 2P. This length is 2P. Similarly, for the third point, measure length 3P. This is your 3P length. Take this much length in your compass, place your compass at third locus point. This is that tangent line passing through the third locus point. Cut an arc. So this is that point, arc point. So this particular length 3P is nothing but this 3P. Likewise, you have to do it for the next step, that is 4P, 5P, 6P, 7P. Last one is 8P. What will be 8P? 8P is nothing but a point. See, I have to measure 8P. What is 8P? If you see this diagram, if I check this line, 8P is what? 8P is nothing but a point. So this is point 8, arc point of the circle. This is that tangent line passing through point 8. So if I take the compass length will be nothing but a point, and this that point will coincide with this particular point. that point will coincide with this particular point, and definitely this point should coincide, then only my condition is suitable or it is satisfied, that is L is equal to 2 pi r. If the length of the wire is equal to the circumferential length, no part of the wire will be either outside the circle or will be behind the circle. So 8p should exactly coincide at this point. Did you understood the part? Did you understood the part? Okay. So you got different locus points, that is P, P1, P2, P3, P4, P5, P6, P7, P8. Now just join these locus points. Since you cannot use scale and you cannot use French curve also, because French curve has limitation. That limitation is you can join French curve when the locus points are very close to each other, are very near to each other. But here you see distance between P and P1 is large. Distance between P1 and P2 is large. So French curve will not work. So in that case, freely you have to join. So if you join freely with free hand, you will get a profile like this, and this profile is known as involute of a circle. This is the final involute profile of a circle. Any doubt so far?
No.
This is for case number one, when length of the line or the wire is equal to circumferential length. Fine. And from this diagram, you can check also whether your drawing is correct or not. How you can check? At the last point, if 8P is not coinciding, that means you have did some mistake. You have did some dimension wrong. So that's why you are not getting the correct curve. If 8P is coinciding, then for this case, the drawing is correct. If 8P is not coinciding, then some thing wrong is there in my drawing, I have to rectify it. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Fine. Okay. Next is the second case. Second case is what? Second case is when length of the line is more than the circumferential length of the circle. That means when I wrap the wire, what will happen? Some portion of the wire will be unwrapped. That I have to show in my involute drawing. How I will show? Let us look into it. This is case number two. See, string length is more than pi d. That means when length of the line or wire is L is more, that is L is more than 2 pi r or pi d length, then how we can draw involute? Everything is same, all the process is same, only there is a slight difference, and that difference is, so in order to draw the involute, you need a circle, draw a circle, then divide your circle into 8 number of equal parts, then you have to give the number into the circle in anti-clockwise direction, then you have to draw the initial tangent line. Now can you tell me what is the length of this initial tangent line? This initial tangent line is nothing but the length of the wire or string length. What is the length of the initial tangent line? Whether it is equal to 2 pi r or it is less than 2 pi r or more than 2 pi r. This length is? This length is how much? From this end to this end. This end is how much? It is more than 2 pi r. Done? Next. So, if I see, this is my one end locus point of my involute. That means when the length of the line is more than 2 pi r, this is that length, this much length is extra, this is that end point which cannot be wrapped completely over the circle, that is your point P. That means this particular point. Okay. L is how much? Say L is equal to 165 mm. say. And this is pi d. See the difference from this end. That is from this end to this end. This is your actual length of the line. And from this end to this particular end, this is your pi d length. How much it is extra? Extra is 165 minus pi d. That much, this much length is extra, which will be unwrapped. Is it clear? Any doubt so far? Hello? Please respond whether it is clear or not.
Yes.
No doubt.
Okay. Next, what is next step is what? Next step is I have to divide this initial tangent line into 8 number of equal parts in order to get 8 different locus points. Let us divide. So I have divided my initial tangent line into 8 number of equal parts. But the question is, which initial tangent line I will divide into 8 number of equal parts? Will I divide this pi d length? Will I divide this pi d length into 8 number of equal parts? Or will I divide this 165 mm length, that is more than pi d length, that is L length, into 8 number of equal part? Can you answer? Because if you see in the last stage step, this pi d length and this length of the line, actual length of the line, is coinciding at this point P. So we have divided that length of the line, which is equal to the circumferential length, into 8 number of equal parts. But in this case, your length of the line is more and pi d is length. So on this initial tangent line, you are getting two lengths. One length is pi d, second length is more than length of pi d, that is 165 mm. So which length of the line you will divide into 8 number of equal parts? The pi d length or more than pi d length? And why? If you understood this concept, then other procedure is same. This is the difference in more than case as well as in less than case. So tell me, which length will I divide into 8 number of equal part? Will I divide the pi d length or will I divide the more than length?
The pi d length.
Why pi d length? Why not more than pi d length?
Sir, because the pi d length will be wrapped up with the circle.
Yes, very good, very good. Because the definition of involute is what? You are getting an involute from a circle. When you wrap something, some length of line, some length of wire over a circle, and if you try to unwrap it, then the locus point, whatever you will get, if you join those locus points, you will get an involute. That means every time I can wrap a circumferential length of 2 pi r or pi d maximum in one revolution. So always remember, whichever is the case, whether it is more than case, less than case, or equal to case, always I will divide my pi d length into 8 number of equal part by set square method in order to generate the involute profile. Is it clear? Any doubt so far? Hello? Please respond whether any doubt is there or not. Okay, so next step is same. So just number all these points. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. How much part is extra? This 8p, this much length is extra. So that's why L is more than pi d. Next step is what? Again, from the different arc points of the circle, you have to draw infinitely long tangent line. And why we are drawing these tangent lines? Because on these tangent lines, I will get the different locus points of involute. So let us draw the tangent line passing through the arc points 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. From point 8, no need to draw. Already we have drawn the tangent line. Next is, I have to mark some distance on this tangent line that is passing through the first locus point of circle. How much length I will mark on this first tangent line? How much length will I mark? Will I mark the length? Will I mark the length 1/8? The distance 1/8. This much distance length will I mark? Or will I mark 1p length? Will I mark this much length? That is 1p length on this tangent line passing through arc point 1. Or will I mark this this particular length? 5d length. Tell me.
Sir, 1/8, 5d length.
Pi d length. No. No.
Sir, 1/8.
No, no, no. You have to mark, you have to mark, take in compass 1p length. Why? I know that definition of involute is what? When I unwrap a certain piece of length from a circle, then I will get an involute. But this is which case? This is more than case. Some portion of length is unwrapped. So this much portion you have to show in involute. So if you take 1/8 that much length in your compass, then how you can show that extra length which is unwrapped? You cannot show. So remember, you have to take always which length? Always that much length which you are unwrapping in the circle. That length can be more than length, it can be less than length, it can be equal to pi d length. So measure, I will measure 1p length in my compass. I will place my compass at point 1. On this tangent line, I will cut an arc. So this is your point P1. This 1P1 is exactly equal to this 1P. Is it clear? Any doubt so far? Hello? Is it clear? Please respond. Fine. Similarly, from the second arc point, I will measure which length? I will measure 2p. 2p. This is 2p. Then 3p. This is 3p. 3p horizontal length. This much length you take in your compass. You keep your compass at point 3. On this tangent line, cut an arc. This will be 3p. Then 4p. This is 4p. 4p. 5p. This is 5p. 5p. 6p. This is your 6p. 6p. 7p. This is your 7p. So this is your 7p. 7p. Next is 8p. Now you tell me where I will mark this 8p length. Will 8p will coincide with point number 8 on the circle? Yes or no? Will this 8p length, if I take in my compass, will it coincide with point number 8 on the circle? Yes or no? Will it coincide? Hello? If you see, it will not coincide. This, now I have to measure, mark this much length, 8p length. Take 8p length in your compass. Place your compass at point 8. So this is my tangent line on which my 8p length will lie. Okay. So I will measure this much length, 8p length in my compass. I will place my compass at point 8. And I will cut an arc over here. This is that particular point which is extra point. Can you see the difference? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Can you observe the difference?
Yes, sir.
Fine. So this will be your that point. So this will be that point. This 8p8, this 8p8 is exactly equal to 8p. That much, that means this 8p8 portion is unwrapped when you try to unwrap the entire length of the wire. And then just join these points with free hand, you will get a curve, and this curve is called involute curve for more than case. What is the difference? Compare from the first diagram. See, in the first case, since point P and 8 were coinciding, so exactly that point you are getting at point number 8. In the second case, some portion of the length of the wire is extra. How much extra? 8P length. See, this is that 8P length extra. If this was the first case, this point P8 might have coincided with point number 8. Yes or no? Yes or no? Hello?
Yes.
Fine. So at last, what you need to do, is just join all these locus points and don't stop over here. Don't stop over here. Fine. And that means you are drawing over here like this. And don't stop over here if this is your point P8. Just join it with the circle. Now it is very much clear that this particular length is unwrapped length. That is more than length. That is L is greater than 2 pi r. Is it clear? Any doubt so far?
No, sir, clear.
Okay, the third case is what? Third case is when length of the wire is lesser than. The third case is when length of the wire is less than 2 pi r. Can you tell me in which part there will be a difference? In which part there will be a difference? See, this from point 8 to this point 8. This is how much? This is your pi d. Now the length of the wire is less. So from point A to P, this is your lesser than length. That means this is length of the wire. This is pi d. So L is lesser than pi d. But remember, always I will divide the pi d length into 8 number of equal parts by set square method. See, here I have divided my pi d length into 8 number of equal parts by set square method. And from this diagram, it is very much clear that this length, which length? This 8P, this much length is what? It is behind the circle. This much length is behind the circle, 8P. So at last, what will be the difference? The difference will be, what is the difference? Difference is, when you try to take the locus point of point number 8, that means you will take P8, this much length in your compass. You will place your compass at point 8. Then on the tangent line passing through point 8, you have to cut an arc. Now tell me whether you will cut an arc on this side or on left hand side. On which side you will cut an arc? On right hand side or left hand side?
Sir, last question. Yes,
I will just finish this portion, then I will make you leave. Tell me, where I will cut an arc for in order to mark this last point, this much point, 8P. This 8P length I have to measure. So I have to cut an arc. So will I
serve left hand side?
Right hand side or left hand side of the tangent line?
Left
I have to cut
third.
It on the left hand side. Very good. That means I have to extend this tangent line this direction. Then I will measure this length, that is 8P length. I will place my compass at point 8 and I will cut an arc. So this is your point 8. That means this much length is what? This much length is behind the circle. Fine. So at last, what you do? At last, what you do, say this is your point 8 and just join it with the circle. So at last, if you join it freely with the hand, see the difference. That means this much portion is behind the circle. And for more than case, this is the diagram. This much portion is ahead of the circle. For equal to case, this is the case. That means the entire length of the wire is completely wrapped. Any doubt so far?
No, sir.
Okay, so with this I end my today's lecture over here. One more part is left, that is I think the tangent and normal, that we cannot discuss today, so that we will discuss in the next class. So till then, we will meet in the next week. Thank you. If anyone is left to give his or her attendance, you can give in the chat box.
Thank you, sir.
Welcome.